Performance-based results would like to welcome you to Advanced Selling Ideas, giving you answers to your most difficult sales obstacles. Your presenter, Paul Cherry, is the president of Performance-Based Results. With 20 years of sales and sales leadership experience, he has worked with over 1,100 clients, including many world-class organizations such as Moody's, Comcast, Pepsi-Cola, Blue Cross Blue Shield, Shell Oil, DuPont, Johnson & Johnson, Medtronic, Harley-Davidson, the American Pharmaceutical Association, as well as numerous small to mid-sized companies in every industry. Having worked with three leading international training organizations, he has personally helped over 75,000 sales professionals improve their skills to secure more business. So listen and learn how these advanced selling ideas can improve your performance-based results.
But let me ask you here, because what we're going to be covering here today is some customer engagement strategies. And I'm sure you face some of these challenges. For example, when you're armed with all this incredible data statistics, and you go out there in front of, let's say, a buyer or purchasing agent or a decision maker, and here you are, you really want to impress and educate this customer, but what do? They come back and they say, yeah, that really looks nice, but it always comes down to what's the best rate you can give me. Or how about those opportunities? Those opportunities where they say, you know what? This really looks good. This looks promising. Can you hurry up? You know, put together some sort of quote or proposal opportunity. But then, I mean, you're jumping through the hoops because you want to impress this opportunity. But all of a sudden, what seemed to be a sense of urgency just fell into a state of complacency where they're stalling. And it just seems that you can't motivate this opportunity anymore. Have you ever faced that challenge? Okay, we're going to be looking at these and more, because we're going to be looking at ways to differentiate ourselves and how we engage our customers by the questions that we ask. Okay, let's get some examples of questions we're asking our customers. Okay. Yes, please.
What is most important to you and your clients?
Are there any other divisions or companies working with you on this project?
Are there any other divisions?
Are there other people joining you in the decision-making
process?
Yes.
Are there others joining you in the decision-making process in which you're trying to create a rapport, a relationship, and by the fourth or fifth question, you notice that the customer is getting a little antagonized or annoyed? So what do we do next? We look up and we ask, are there any questions? And what do you think the answer is? No, but thank you very much. And what do they ask for? Could you leave any literature with us and your business card, and we will? Isn't that true? Oh, and my last question was the implication question to size up the opportunity. And my question was, so what is your concern if you don't achieve your goals in these coming years? What do you think his answer was? I'll be without a job. My point here is, this is an interesting. It's one thing to ask questions, but as we really try to understand the decision-making process, we're going to get all kinds of answers. But it's really to take those answers and really sift through those answers to really understand what our customers are saying, what they're not saying, what are some of the hidden agendas and motivations to really make sense of these relationships so that we can stay focused and continue the successful record that we want to achieve. It's been a pleasure to work with you, and I wish you the best of success. Thank you.